So consider the following statements. First question. So the International Court of Arbitration is a UN mandated body. It is not correct. It is not UN mandated body. So International Court of Arbitration is a branch of the International Chamber of Commerce, not a UN body. So, and one of the world's leading institution providing international arbitration service. The International Court of Arbitration is known as resolving international commercial business and business disputes. International commercial and business dispute administering more than half of all arbitration disputes worldwide. The ICC seat is located in Paris. And the international second is the International Chamber of Commerce is an international business organizing spanning virtually every sector of private enterprise. The International Chamber of Commerce is an international business organization spanning virtually every sector of private enterprises. It is correct. The International Chamber of Commerce is an international business organization, and it is with hundreds of thousands of members of companies in over the 130 countries, spanning virtually every sector of private enterprises. Next question. Consider the following statements regarding Foreigners Act 1946. The act has been established to enforce. The act has been established to enforce a law relation, law relating to the legal status and protection of immigrants. So, regarding Foreigners Act, so the act has been established to enforce a law relating to the legal status and protection of immigrants. So, it empowers the central government to detain a person until he is deported back to his or her own country. It empowers the central government to detain a person who is deported back to his own country. The Foreigners Act 1946 has been established to enforce the law relating to the legal status and protection of immigrants. It empowers the central government to detain a person until he is deported back to his or her own country. The main objective of this act is to end with the recommending, regulating, and restricting foreigners among other things, their presence and their continuous presence in India. That confers several powers of central government in persons of the entity of foreigners or immigrants that their presence in the in our country and regard to their departure. Okay. So next question. Consider the following statements regarding Global Cooling Innovation Summit. So it is being organized by Ministry of Environment. No. Environment Forest not. And Climate Change not. Global Innovation Summit. So it is not related to, it is inaugurated by the Science and Technology. Minister of Science and Technology. Okay. So it is first of its kind solution based event that explores pathway to address the climate threat from the growing demand of room air condition. So it is first kind of solution focused on the event explore pathway to address climate threat from the growing demand of room air condition. Jointly organized by Science and Technology, Government of India, Rocky Mountain Institute of Alliance, Institute of Alliance and Energy Efficiency, so and CEPT University. The summit also launching Global Cooling Prize Mission Innovation aims to super developed of residential cooling solution at this phase five times. Okay, so thank you.